servant of God. Well done. Major Joshua Randall Pyle was born in Panama City, Panama, to his parents who were immigrants from Barbados. Like many other West Indians, they migrated to Panama to see work on the canal in a hope to better life opportunity for their family. He was the first of the, for his mother Hilda, but he was raised by his grandparents. He did not speak much about his father as he played a very little part in his upbringing. It must have been his grandmother's Christian faith which influenced Daddy to become a born-again believer. As a youngster, he came into contact with the Salvation Army and came through the various sections culminating within answering the call for officership, full-time service. Daddy entered the Salvation Army Training College in the early 50s, and on graduation served in numerous appointments throughout the region, to include Belize, Jamaica, Panama, Barbados, Trinidad, and Antigua. He also served in Pasadena, USA. His final appointment was at Jamaica City of Queens, New York, USA. Daddy, as part of his development, also attended Brandon College for Officers in England. Daddy loved the Lord and the Salvation Army, and he was dedicated to the Army's mission. He was filled with the Holy Spirit. He would from time to time go over courses of songs when the leader may have been inclined to finish and stand and raise his hand in adoration, praise, and worship. Many times, he would revert to his native tongue, Spanish, and pray, but at times, it was not even that. It must have been speaking in tongues. For I could not understand what he was saying. He must have been filled with the Holy Ghost. That he loved his calling, and I am told that as a young officer, he would go around the neighborhood to transport young people to church on his bicycle. I can recall witnessing him right here in this citadel. Service started, and during the singing, he turned to Mama, said something to her, and left the meeting, returning a few moments later with two junior soldiers. He was a faithful shepherd, leaving none behind. Daddy was in the business of building and refurbishing or maintaining army properties. He believed that God's people had to have the best. Second was not an option. I remember the night we arrived at the Welcome Street Co in Barbados, walking past the church, down alley, to the quarters which was situated at the back. Daddy, after putting down the bars, turned to examine the church building, which was in need of extreme repair. He was a hands-on individual. Many times individuals seeking the captain or the major would be surprised to meet him up a ladder, nailing or painting or shoveling something. Daddy was a leader. He would be seen in all his meetings, including open air, on the march with the troops, and he always made sure that his family was there. His desire was for all of his children to be musicians. He was a cornet player and made sure that the four of us learned to play. We had no say in this matter. I remember many times trying to find an excuse for not attending practice, but that did not work. No one could accuse him of not having his children in a meeting or participating. Once we played that duet at an artist concert, that is Robert and I, that was enough for him to have us play in the open air meeting, at the Christmas kettle, and of course, do the service in the band. His family played an important part in his plan in the army.
Natty Natty, Grandpa would say to his grandchildren whenever he corrects them. He was a disciplinarian, not scared of anyone. If you stepped out of line, he was the first to speak sternly to you. But right after, he was as calm as a lamb and ready to move on. He loved his grandchildren and his great-grand, and we loved him too. Grandpa, like the clockwork, every night would leave his television the same time and go to Grandma. And they both would pray. They both believed in the power of prayer. He always took the time to mention and call his grandchildren's name, his in-laws, and his two great-grands. Grandpa believed in the power of prayer.
At birth, that's my birth, Daddy took me from my mother, Mama, when we got home, took me outside and raised me to the heavens and asked God to take me back if I was to become a nuisance. This was his question of God for his children. He loved all of us. He loved us all and made sure he did not spoil us. He blessed us. I journeyed to Jamaica to attend university there. I took the opportunity to visit Raytown, where I was born. Didn't know it before. On arrival to the community, I explained the purpose for my visit and was immediately taken to the house where I was entertained because the lady there remembered my parents and the good work they did when they were stationed there some 20 plus years prior. This is true of every appointment in which they served. Daddy had to retire, but this did not slow him down. He still found himself attending services every Sunday once able, and if there was another evening meeting, he was there. The absence of no evening meeting was hard for him to deal with, for when he worked, he was accustomed to a packed weekend, starting on Saturday, open air at the market, knee drill 6 a.m. on Sunday morning, every Sunday morning, directory class at 10 a.m., followed by wholeness meeting at 11, Sunday school at 3 p.m., open air at 6, followed by march to the citadel, and salvation meeting at 7. Wow. That was how it was for him after spending 90% of his time at the office and court during the week, including his civic duties to juvenile probation as a probation officer. Daddy gone. Daddy gone. On Monday, 16 November 2015, sometime between 10 and 11:30 a.m., Daddy was promoted to glory. As I entered the house following this distress call, I was feeling down, but on seeing his remain, my tears dried up. And I noted that he looked so at peace. And I said, Mama, that he seems to be smiling. She remarked that he has been smiling with her the entire morning as he went about his chores. Daddy always said that he wasn't going to give us any headache or make us worry. And that morning he did just as he promised. He woke up, cleansed his body, had a breakfast, and tried calling Altia to inquire about some medication that he had received earlier that weekend. And then he retired to his mid-morning nap. The clock alarm and Mama went to the room to stop it and to wake him. He normally would have gotten up at the sun, but this time he was gone. He was found on his back, just waiting for the undertakers to take his body. I am convinced that he has gone to be with his Savior and Lord. He was indeed a truly dedicated, Holy Ghost-filled officer, pastor, a loving and dedicated husband, father, grandfather, and great-grandfather. I now take this opportunity to thank all of you this afternoon for turning up here, those who took time out to call, visit, text, or email to convey condolences. Thanks are also extended to the CDS, Colonel Sir Trevor Thomas, Major Fredericks, and Captain Duplessis, following the Antigua Barbuda Defense Force Band, who are here with us this afternoon, to participate in this celebration. Thanks to you also, bandsmen. The Pyle family is a very blessed family. Amen. And because of that blessing, God has given us some good friends along the way. I want to take the opportunity to also thank Major Hajiman and Mrs. Hajiman, our DC, and all the members of the St. John's Civil Corps for all that you have done for us thus far. They adopted us as family way back from 76. Right? Yeah. And this last 2 weeks, there was nothing that we couldn't ask for that they weren't ready to do. Especially George. George was adamant that we're getting this one right. For you see, when he slacking up, that was always the one to pull him straight. So he made sure that we got this one correct. But I'd also like to thank Dave Lester Payne for voicing the announcement. Karen Bell of Caribbean Printing in Anguilla for volunteering to print. Sorry, Tortola. Karen Bell of Caribbean Printing in Tortola for volunteering to print today's program free of cost. Nurses Romancia Dover, Cicely Nathaniel, Elaine Davis, thank you very much. ABS TV Radio, ZDK, for playing the announcement. And if I've forgotten anyone, sorry, but I remembered in the course of time. Daddy, your wife of 55 years, your children, your in-laws, grandchildren, and great-grands are proud to have known you and shared in your life. We are proud to be yours. Major Joshua Randall Pye, servant of God, well done. Rest from thy love and blood. The battle fought, the victory won. Enter thy master's joy.